Hey everybody, welcome back to the BowlerX.com channel. I am JR Raymond, I'm your host, and I'm here inside BowlerX Pro Shop and Training Center in Waterford, Michigan, where we are actually inside Waterford Lanes. This is a beautiful center where I do most of my videos nowadays. But today, I'm gonna talk to you about one of those key components in bowling that most people don't really pay a whole lot of attention to, but it can cause a lot of problems for people if they're not focusing on it enough during practice. That thing today, your elbow. What are we going to do with our elbow? We need to figure out where it needs to go, where it needs to point, and what it can affect all throughout your swing. So we're going to do that here in a minute. Stay tuned.
They say bowling is a dying sport.
A dying sport.
I disagree. I disagree.
BowlerX.com for the love of bowling.
Hey, for those of you that don't know, you could always come see me. I'm up here at Waterford Lanes in Waterford, Michigan, where I have the Pro Shop inside the bowling center, and we can do whatever you need. We can drill you a bowling ball, we can check your fit, we can bring you out on lanes, we can do lessons, we can do whatever you need. We'll get you taken care of. So come and see me or Greg up here, 7100 Cooley Lake Road. Even if you're not from the state, if you're out of state, come and see me anyway. I'm up here Monday through Wednesday from 3 p.m. until 8 p.m. On the weekends, you can probably catch me every once in a while when I'm not bowling. Greg's up here on weekends. Pretty much whenever you need us, just let me know. Hit up BowlerXTrainingCenter@gmail.com. Shoot me an email to see if we are in. If not, find our Facebook page. You can see our hours there as well. So let's go check out this video now. All right, so we're going to talk a little bit today about the elbow and how it affects your game, how it can change your swing, how it can make you not throw it the way you want to throw it, all kinds of different things. But first, make sure to hit that like button. If you appreciate everything we do here, trying to teach bowlers to be a little bit better, make sure to hit that like button. Also, if you want to support the channel, you want to support me, head over to the JR Raymond channel and click that join button where you get exclusive access to all kinds of different footage, like behind the scenes, actual bowling footage at PBA events and all kinds of stuff like that. Plus, I give away prizes every time I bowl an event. I either give away a bowling ball or some type of accessory, ball, bag, shoe, all that kind of stuff. So make sure to head over there. You have to be a member in order to win. But today we're going to talk a little bit about the elbow. The elbow is important because it is what can cause your swing to either be out of line or get your hand in a bad position. So when we look at coming to the approach, if our elbow is to the outside, our elbow pointing of the elbow facing that wall there. If we get to the outside, our hand is to the outside, right? So what do we need to do? We need to rotate this elbow on our swing and keep it more to the inside, because what do we always hear Randy talk about on the PBA show? We always hear him talk about playing the inside part of the ball. Well, what does that mean? Well, that means your fingers are to the left. If you were to draw a straight line from the ball, actually even just cut it in quadrants, you have an equator and then you have a vertical line directly above, your fingers are on the inside part of that line and below the equator. So you're more this way than anything. So as you're underneath the ball, you can then go from inside to outside and you rotate this way, but it's impossible to get your hand inside if your elbow is facing to the right. You just can't do it, it's not possible. So we wanna make sure we're keeping that elbow facing inward. And the other good thing about keeping the elbow inward is it can help our swing be a little bit more free. If we're trying to keep that elbow, you know, out or in, now we're outside here and we're out to where the elbow's still pointing that way, and the swing can only go so high. But as soon as we rotate and we get everything inside to where the elbow is facing our hip, okay, so think of the point of your elbow facing your hip and this part of your elbow facing the wall or the ceiling when you get back, now we have the ability of going as high as we want with our swing, right? So now that's not necessarily a good thing for a lot of people, because a lot of people are trying to cut their swing back. If you want to cut your swing back, which we can talk about in another video, that's just simply keeping everything directly behind you. Don't let this shoulder rotate, because as soon as you rotate, now you can actually get some movement up there and you can get the swing up. So then you can stay inside, keep everything inside, tuck it inside, elbow stays in, rotate around. So when you look at releases, like I just posted a video on my channel the other day about how the hand stays to the inside and it stays to the lower part, you'll notice eventually they do get to the outside, but it's all right at the bottom of the swing. It's all right at the end. You got to go from inside out. So it's inside, then rotate outside in order to create maximum power, maximum rotation, all that stuff. So that can help you not only get your hand in a better strong position, but it can help you with consistency and it can help your rotation and rev rate as well. So next time you go practice, make sure you're paying attention to that elbow. See if you can keep that elbow facing your hip as long as you want or as long as you can. A good drill to do this, try to throw backup balls. You know, just try to throw a backup ball and keep your elbow in. Because if you can throw a backup ball from that spot with your hand inside here and just keep it there, then you go from that spot in the very last second, you rotate your hand around it, that creates maximum turn. So that'll be really cool. So go try that. Let me know how it works. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Comment below. Let me know, do you have a problem with this? Is this something you need to work on? And what are some other things that you need to work on? What are some other things you want to see a video on to show you how to correct? But that's all I got for you today. Again, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you need anything pro shop wise, come and see me up here at Waterford Lanes. Otherwise, you can go to BowlerX.com and get all of your bowler needs. But I'm out of here for today. We'll see you later.